Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Naruto Explain here, bringing you guys another board to a Two Blue Vortex discussion. Today, I want to talk to you guys about a rather unexpected but very obvious plot twist that we got at the end of the last chapter, chapter 14 of Boruto Two Blue Vortex. We had a moment where Shikamaru made the ultimate sin as Hokage, which is he assisted in the escape of Boruto, which led to a line by one of the two elders who warned Shikamaru that this would not go unpunished and that there would be consequences that follow, which is why in today's newest Naruto Explain video, I wanted to talk to you guys about why we need to have a serious conversation about why one of these consequences might be Kakashi returning as Hokage and why this is a much needed plot twist for the story moving forward. So as we all know, during chapter 14 of Boruto Two Blue Vortex, when Shikamaru found himself struggling to fight against what his memories were telling him about Boruto, that he was a traitor who couldn't be trusted because he killed Naruto. As the interrogation was going on and we saw how things were escalating with Ibiki hitting Boruto and slamming his face into the desk and how quickly things were getting tense, Shikamaru kept going back and forth to his conversation with Boruto and all the small things, they were adding up but not adding up all the way. Like how Shikamaru wanted to trust Boruto but not understanding why he trusts Boruto, but only that he does, and things like omnipotence, the very concept of it, they were literally being erased from his memory. All he knew was that Boruto and Kawaki switched, but he couldn't understand why, making it impossible for him to fully connect everything that he saw with his eyes and the issues with his memory. But eventually, he came to the conclusion that Boruto is Naruto's son. He said, "I might have zero proof of it, but I need to protect Naruto's kid to ensure he doesn't die here." And this led to Boruto getting help from Shikamaru in his escape. That brings up the repercussions and why, from a narrative perspective, this makes the most sense to have Kakashi brought back into the story right here. So let's start with what we know from the political climate of the Boruto Two Blue Vortex era, because that's very important to understand that to get the whole premise of this video. So the death of Naruto, it led to there being an uproar in the ninja world where things have rightfully gotten a little bit unstable, in that the other villages, they are now hunting Boruto and they've been applying pressure onto Konoha and Shikamaru by extension because he's the Hokage. The whole situation just reeked of, you need to do something or else we're gonna do something. And we saw it in the flashbacks. Boruto was hiding from ninjas of the other villages and he was about to get caught by 20 of them before Kashin Koji stepped in and said, "Hey fam, no need to kill these ninja. I'm gonna get you out of here." Meanwhile, we learned that the elders are telling Shikamaru that the other Kages, they're getting very restless with his leadership decisions in Konoha, and they reminded him that his 3-year delay before officially becoming Hokage, that deadline, it is up and he needs to make a decision. The decision, of course, was that Shikamaru needs to make it official by having the Hokage ceremony on top of the Hokage rooftop, which normally happens after the Hokage has their face engraved on the stone monument and after the Hokage gets the formality vote from the Jonin Council, because it's a formality vote, because it's the feudal lord who ultimately chooses the person who becomes Hokage. Take a shot for every time I said Hokage, you're definitely drunk. This is why there's no Hokage Shikamaru face, and we know that in the flash forward sequence, when Boruto versus Kawaki's battle takes place, which is another glaring red siren that is flashing right before our very eyes right now. Based on what we know, there is this pressure to have someone be officially named Hokage. It's not crazy to question if Shikamaru holds on to his Hokage title after such a bold move that he's now told will anger the feudal lord and that it will result in ramifications, because killing Boruto, it was described as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and basically what he did, it was treason. Even though we as the audience know via dramatic irony that he was right about this whole thing, but the characters in universe, they don't know that, and that, my friends, is why this conflict, it works oh so well. Someone is going to have to be named, and they can't just go pick some random person right now when the other Kage are questioning Konoha's leadership. The village that is the leader of the Shinobi Alliance via the treaty after the Ninja War, which makes it impossible for you to go to someone like Konohamaru and say, "Hey fam, you're gonna be the new Hokage now. Good luck." it's bad optics to have appointed two Hokage back-to-back when the last one is seen as having fumbled in the court of public opinion. You have a better chance of telling me as a Giants fan that Daniel Jones is the quarterback of my future after last night's game where he couldn't throw a deep ball to save his life. It's the same thing with this type of a situation, naming someone like Konohamaru Hokage after Shikamaru, which is why I think it's time to question if the elders will name Kakashi as Hokage and get the feudal lord to sign back off on it. That would explain why the elders have been such a prominent figure in the story, and they were on board with Kakashi being named Hokage after Tsunade was left in a coma by pain, and they signed off when the time came for him to replace Tsunade after the war. While I get it, a lot of fans hate the elders, mostly due to how they're portrayed in the story, they serve their role in the story itself, and it is an important one, one that I don't think enough fans actually understand. They are the bridge between the Feudal Lord and the Hidden Leaf Village. The Feudal Lord is the one who owns the Land of Fire. It's land that their family owns. Think of the Feudal Lord like the person who owns the land where this giant park has been built on. He owns the land where all the houses have been built on inside of that city. The Feudal Lord is basically the guy who's allowing you to build your house there to live on it. He's the guy who owns that park that all the kids play in. The Hokage is basically the mayor of the town per se, or he's the groundkeeper who is in charge of making sure that the park has a sandbox, has sand inside of it, and the grass is cut and that the playground is safe to kind of have kids play on. The Feudal Lord is the one who sustains the village by giving the village the money it needs to operate, because even with this technology boom, there's not enough money coming in from the ninja villages in order to operate. This has always been the case. The Hokage has authority, but they answer to the Feudal Lord. Strategically, placing Kakashi back in the Hokage position, it erases the doubts and it offers a sign of strength and stability. It's a play on nostalgia, and it builds on the trust from Kakashi's time as Hokage, where in universe there are these rose-tinted glasses, as is the case like in our own world, where we have politicians leave office all the time, and years later they're remembered more fondly than their actual time as leader was. Kakashi was the one who set up the Shinobi Union that groomed the current generation of five Kage for the position of Kage of the respective villages, including Shikamaru, which, as a reminder, Naruto was never in that group in the Shinobi Union because he never became a Jonin after the war, because that's an anime filler scene with the condition that Naruto, someone who is not book smart, passed an exam when Naruto couldn't read a book to save his life. If it didn't have pop-up figures and crayons, Naruto wasn't understanding nothing. Kakashi is the one who started the technology expansion in the Land of Fire and grew the economy to the point where all Naruto had to do was get behind the wheel of the car and just not crash it, which Naruto avoided doing, and he even expanded on what Kakashi did by doing things like the ninja tech department being allowed to have Katasuke make those ninja tech tools, one of many things that Naruto did as Hokage. Kakashi, as the son of the famed White Fang and the student of the fourth Hokage and the sensei to the seventh Hokage, he's someone who has the credibility that the Feudal Lords look for when naming someone as Hokage, and he showed as Hokage he could do a good job running the village. The only issue is around his neck. He has a noose that comes from the fact that he was the one who fought so hard alongside Naruto in order to get Sasuke pardoned, and Sasuke helped the Hokage's killer escape. That is a stain on his legacy that won't ever go away. But given how far things have fallen and given the game of optics, this is their only real option right now. Longtime viewers of the channel, y'all know that Kakashi becoming Hokage is something that I've been saying is gonna happen at some point during the time skip in terms of the storyline, which time skip I'm basically including the Boruto Two Blue Vortex as that, because people refer to this as the time skip. Something I've been pounding the gavel on because narratively just makes the most sense from a sheer narrative perspective. The bones are there for him to step back into this role, and it's not really an age thing either, which that's like the common complaint that I see when people say, why do you want Kakashi to be Hokage again? That makes no sense. He's too old, fam. So I thought this should be common knowledge as to why age is not the issue you think it is, but I'm going to elaborate it on it for Those guys who are a bit confused as to why Age of Kakashi isn't as big of a deal as you think. This isn't like the third Hokage, who took back over the role of Hokage at the age of 56 when Minato died in the Ninetales attack at the ripe age of 24 years old and wasn't even in his prime. And there was a concern back then that Hiruzen needed to start grooming a successor to take back over the Hokage position due to his age, which, as a reminder, Hiruzen died at age 69. 69 minus 13 is 56. That man just aged super hard and looked like he was 80 even though he was 69. Kakashi during the war arc, he's 31 years old. Right now in Boruto Tupu Vortex, which is 19 years after the Fourth Ninja War, that now puts Kakashi at 50 years old. A full 6 years younger than Hiruzen when Sarutobi stepped back into the Hokage position. For comparison, that would make him a full year younger than when Tsunade became Hokage at the age of 51. If it's good enough for Tsunade, who was a full year older than Kakashi when she became Hokage, then it's good enough for Kakashi, who is still at an age where if he needs to operate at a high level without getting gassed the way that Hiruzen was when he fought Orochimaru, he could. That would also explain why there's a lack of new face on the Hokage Monument, because you don't need one if the sixth Hokage comes back. From a conflict perspective, it works because it now makes you look at Shikamaru's promise to help Boruto a lot more differently now. How can he assist Boruto if he no longer has the position of Hokage to do so? That's instant conflict because it's the element of the unknown. We know Boruto is innocent. We know that Shikamaru is aware of it, but will Kakashi make the same connections as Shikamaru, who struggled to make them, or will Omnipotence win out with him as well, like it did with Ino? Will there be a political pressure on Kakashi to have Boruto hunt it down? Absolutely, that's unavoidable. Even if he figures out the truth, he's in the same position as Shikamaru, having to help him remotely, and he'd be at the disadvantage in that Ino is likely gonna refuse to connect him to Boruto unless something drastic happens that makes her change her mind. There's a few different storylines that have been baked into this whole situation that allows for some very, very messy writing, which by messy, I mean basically conflict, which in storytelling, that's what you want. Conflict is a vehicle to tell the story you want to tell. When there's no conflict, you have a boring story. Conflict is not always action, but every story has to have conflict. There's a domino effect at play here if you pull the trigger on Kakashi's Hokage. If we go the route of Shikamaru staying on as Hokage, it's not a bad thing. I halfway expect him to stay on, even though narratively, I will die on the hill. This is the wisest choice you can make unless you have a really, really big payoff that sets up as a reward for fans, like how we got the payoff of Sasuke. He's a tree in the storyline after he was kept out of the Tubu Vortex story for so long, and people are like, oh my god, where is Sasuke? Did Sasuke die? Is Sasuke making babies somewhere? Or the way that the new Chainsaw Man chapter paid off the storyline from several chapters ago, which the chapter review on my Anime Explained channel is over here on the left, and over here on the right, we got the Boruto Tubu Vortex chapter review for those of you guys who have not seen it just yet. And as always, remember those magic words, baby. Send you DNA is love, send you DNA is life, because Hashirama said so.